Hey there, there's been a lot of questions on the YouTubes about vocoder plugins, vocoder type effects inside of Cubase. As it stands, there isn't an in-the-box vocoder, but I'm going to show you one of the many techniques that you can use to come up with a vocoder style effect by using the generate harmony function inside of Cubase. The very first thing you're going to need before you can go ahead with this vocoder type effect is some chords in a chord track, which I have up the top, preferably triggering a sound like a piano. And of course, you're going to need a lead vocal. And I'm just using a sample here over the top of this chord track, which I've come up with. When I double click on the lead vocal event, I can see the waveform down the bottom. And now I can go up to VariAudio and I can activate VariAudio and have a look at the actual blocks that have been sung, and they represent notes. So that's my melody. I need to go in and make sure that that melody's spot on correct and that there's no little extra bits in there. I can see one there, so I can just use the controls to glue that together. That should be one long note. That's really good. VariAudio has done a great job of analyzing that, and it represents the melody perfectly. Now I'm going to go down to functions and select extract MIDI. And there's a few different modes that I can use, but I'm going to select just notes and none of this pitch bend data, which represents the variations in the vocals and the vibrato. So once I select that, there's a few other options, but I'm going to select project clipboard, which is going to copy this MIDI that I'm extracting, and I'm going to paste that up here on this melody double synth track. So that sounds not exactly perfect, but we can of course use the presets in Retrolog to go and change to another preset. And what I'm looking for is that kind of synthesized sound that you'd hear with a vocoder type effect. And I probably won't find it until I've actually got the harmonies in there anyway. That's definitely sounding a little better anyway. But let's go and focus on the other chores that we have to do to get this vocoder happening. Right, let's go and select that melody event and up to the audio menu and then down to generate harmony voices. I'm selecting 3 harmony voices and 0 vibrato strength because I don't want my harmonies moving around with the vibrato and the pitch data. I want it to sound almost robotic-like. So now that I've done that, you can see that we've got 3 harmony voices, soprano, alto, and tenor. And my next step would then be to go and drop the volume and pan them a little bit. And of course, now it's a matter of playing around with the actual volume and the stereo imaging, and of course, the actual voicing of the parts themselves. So my parts are too low, so I'm just turning them up a bit. So that's starting to sound more respectable in terms of the vocals, but that synth line could become pretty annoying. So now it's a matter of going through and finding a preset that might settle in with the vocals. And the good thing about Retrolog 2, again, is there's so many presets in there which you can choose. It's just a matter of being patient and using your ears. The final piece of the puzzle is to highlight all of your harmony events and then go into VariAudio and start using the formant to change the tonal sound of the vocals. You could do them all together, as I've done, or you could go in and change them and tweak them all one by one, even note by note, if that's what takes your fancy. Hey, thanks for taking this time to stop by and check out this quick video on how to create an easy vocoder type effect in Cubase. Please subscribe to the Cubase YouTube channel for plenty more videos on techniques shown in this video. And of course, give us a thumbs up if you've learned something. Catch you soon.